శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వరరావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ 2008 లో స్థాపించిన కళాశాలలో ఎన్బిఏ, నాక్ ఏ గ్రేడ్ మరియు ఐఎస్ఓ సర్టిఫికేషన్ సాధించిన మొట్టమొదటి కళాశాల శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వరరావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ త్వరలో ఎటోనమస్ కాబోతుంది.
2014 లో ఐఎస్ఓ గుర్తింపు, 2015 లో రాష్ట్ర ప్రభుత్వంచే ఏ గ్రేడ్, 2016 లో నాక్ ఏ గ్రేడ్, ఇప్పుడు ఎన్బిఏ సాధించిన సంస్థ శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వరరావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ.
Good morning, students. In the last class, we have discussed about AC analysis of differential amplifier. So in that we have discussed about we have derived the equation for differential gain, as well as we have derived the equation for the common mode gain, and we have found the common mode rejection ratio value. So this is the common mode rejection ratio. We can see here CMRR, which is the ratio of AD to the AC. So from this equation we can see that as AD increases, CMRR increases, and if AC decreases, the CMRR also increases. So for increasing the CMRR, we are having the two possibilities, that is either increasing AD, that is the differential gain, or by decreasing the common mode gain. These are the two things we have to do to improve the CMRR. So in AC analysis, we have observed that CMRR is going to depend upon these parameters. Here in this equation you can see, that is RS, HIE, 2RE, 1 plus HFE, RS plus HIE. So see here, HIE, HFE are the transistor parameters. So if we take a transistor, the two identical transistors we are going to take, there is no possibility for changing these values, that is HFE and HIE. So there is only the possibility we are having, that is either we are going to increase these resistance values. So here you can see the resistance values, that is the emitter resistance value, mainly the emitter resistance value. If we change the emitter resistance value, we can change the CMRR. From this equation, we can observe that if we change the emitter resistance value, we can change the CMRR. And in the same manner, so here in this equation, you can see here, CMRR is equal to AD by AC. So this is the equation for AD. For improving AD, we have to increase RC value also. So if we increase RC value, then the CMRR, the AD will be increased. If AD increases, CMRR will be increasing. So by increasing this RE value, RC value or RE value, we can increase the CMRR. So now we are going to concentrate on this concept for improving the CMRR. So we are going to discuss about these things in this class. So now we are going to see what are the possibilities are there for improving this CMRR. So here we can see methods for improving CMRR. So it can be increased, it can be improved by increasing the value of R. As we have discussed one now, but by increasing the value of resistance RE, so we can improve CMRR. If RE increases, the CMRR increases. But here we are having some problem by increasing this RE. So RE, what we are going to concentrate on is RE. Where is this RE? This is the emitter resistance of a differential amplifier, and this is a circuit which is included in operational amplifier. So operational amplifier we have to manufacture on a single chip, a small chip. So if we increase the resistance value, then the chip area, the area required for that is also increases. We have to keep in this mind. Okay, so this is one of the problems we are getting when we are going to increase this resistance value. But we are having only the possibility to increase this resistance value. So this can be improved by using a circuit which is called the constant current bias circuit, So that circuit provides a constant current and provides high resistance, high emitter resistance. So constant current bias circuit and another circuit is nothing but current mirror circuit. So these are used to increase the value in the place of, we are going to replace these circuits in the place of emitter resistor, and we are going to increase the resistance value as well as maintaining the current constant. Maintaining the current constant, we are not going to change the current value, but we are increasing the resistance value. So by using these two circuits, we can improve CMRR. We can improve the common mode rejection ratio. That is how we are going, that is here we are going to increase the resistance value RE by replacing it with a constant current bias circuit. So here, coming to this circuit, so this circuit is constant current source circuit. Here you can see this is a constant current source circuit. So in this, this is a differential amplifier. Read the dotted portion. You can see here the dotted portion circuit is nothing but constant current source circuit. In the place of emitter resistor, we are going to use this constant current source circuit. So it constitutes of a R1 resistor, R2 resistor, and R3 resistor, and three resistors. It constitutes of a three resistances and one transistor. So one transistor. So making this provides a constant current. So that we are going to observe that now. So how this circuit is going to provide a constant current? So now we are going to replace this constant current source in the place of emitter resistor RE. So here the base current of Q3 is small. So here we are going to take Q3 transistor in constant current source. So here you can observe that the base is connected to ground through a resistor R1, and it is connected to minus V through a resistor R2. So hence there is no source. We can say that where the base current is very small. Okay, so we are going to neglect the base current. So now we are going to write KVL to the Q3, base emitter loop of Q3. So we have I into R1. So in this loop we are going to write the KVL. I into R1. Next, in this way we are coming, I into R2. The same current is going to flow through this, because we are at this node. So we are assuming that the base current, so here I is going to be divided into two parts at this node. Actually, that is, it is going to divide into I as well as it is going to divide into IB. So as you have assumed that, observed that the base current of the transistor is very small. So we have neglected that, and approximately this I current is going to flow through R2. That means the current through R1 is same as current through R2 also. So because of that reason, we are going to write minus I into R1 minus I into R2, and then we are going in this manner. So we are going to this end. So see here, we can observe that. See here, we can observe that the current is going to flow towards BE. So from this, we can say that the current is going to, yes, we can observe here that minus I into R1 minus I into R2 plus VE is equal to 0. From this equation, we can write that VE is equal to I into R1 plus I into R2, taking current common, I into R1 plus R2. Finally, we are going to get I is equal to VE by R1 plus R2. As we know that VE is a constant supply voltage, R1 is a constant resistance value, and R2 is a constant resistance value. So I will be constant. From this, you can observe that these three are constants. So these three are fixed, nothing but fixed values. So I will be also a constant value. So VB, from this here, from this circuit diagram, you can see that VB, that is VB is at this node, base node of Q3 transistor. So VB is given by minus I into R1. So where I, we have found the equation for I. So we are going to place that equation here. So we are going to get minus V by R1 plus R2 into R1. So emitter voltage. Next, we are going to find the emitter voltage, V. So voltage at this emitter terminal of Q3 transistor. So V is equal to VB, voltage at the base terminal, minus voltage drop across base to emitter terminal. That is nothing but VB. Here you can see in the circuit diagram, that is VB. So VB minus VB. So IE3 is equal to, so IE3 is the current flow going to flow through, the current flowing through R3 resistor. So IE3 is equal to VE, voltage at emitter terminal, minus of minus VE divided by the resistance in that part. By voltage division rule, we are going to write this formula. IE3 is equal to VE, voltage at emitter, minus of minus VE divided by R3, that is the resistance in this part, that becomes VE plus VE by R3. Then VE, as we know that VE is equal to VE plus VE, this becomes VE plus VE divided by R3. Next one, VE plus VE, VE. So here we are going to write VE plus VE. So VE is equal to, in the place of VE, we can write VB minus VE. Already we have discussed this here. VB is equal to minus VE into R1 divided by R1 plus R2. So in the place of VE, we are going to write this equation. So this VB, this is VB minus VB, VB plus VE divided by R3. So from this equation, we are going to write by solving this equation, we are going to get VE into R2 divided by R1 plus R2 minus VBE divided by R3. So, by this equation, so here VE minus VE and plus VE will get cancel each other. So, we are going to get this equation. So, IE3 is approximately equal to IC3. So constant current flows through the circuit. The internal resistance of the constant current source is very high. So as we know that the constant current source produces a very high internal resistance. So this circuit produces a very high internal resistance. So very high internal resistance, which we require, that is what we require. So we get that emitter resistance, high emitter resistance with constant current, and by replacing this circuit, the AC becomes, that is the current, that is the common mode gain. So the common mode gain becomes zero. So if common mode gain is zero, then CMRR would be very high. So if CMRR is high, then the operational amplifier, that is differential amplifier, performs better. So but this is having one drawback. The drawback is nothing but temperature. So if But as we know that the transistor is a semiconductor device, so the parameter that is HFE, HFE is going to depend upon HFE or the current inside. It is going to depend upon temperature also, because as the temperature is going to increase, we can say that as the temperature is increasing, then we can say that the parameters will change. So due to these changes in the temperature, the transistor parameters will change. The transistor is nothing but it is built with two diodes. So because of that, the temperature variations, the diode current is also going to change. As you know that the diode current equation, here you can see ID is equal to I naught into E power VD by eta VT minus 1. So VD is nothing but the diode bias voltage, and eta is constant. For silicon, it is its value is 2, and for germanium, its value is 1. And VT is volt equivalent of temperature, so which is going to depend upon temperature divided by 11,600. So because of this, that means here the temperature VT depends upon temperature. As temperature increases, the diode current is also going to change. So because of that, the transistor parameters is also going to change. So this can be adjusted. That means this can be compensated. Compensated is nothing but this can be adjusted by using this circuit. That is, we are going to replace the R2 resistor. In the above circuit, we have observed that R2 resistor. So R2 resistor is replaced with two diodes, D1 and D2. Now we are going to see the equation. So here, by observing this circuit, VB is equal to minus V plus 2VD. So voltage at node B is equal to minus VEE plus 2VD. That is voltage drop across these two diodes. So nothing but VE is equal to voltage at emitter. VB, as we have said like this, and VE is equal to VB minus VBE. As we know that, as we have studied in the last circuit diagram, in the same manner, VE is equal to VB minus VBE. So in the place of VB, we are going to write it as minus VEE plus 2VD minus VBE. IE3 is equal to VE plus VBE divided by R3. So finally we are going to get minus VE plus 2VD minus VBE plus VBE divided by R3. By solving this equation, we are going to get 2VD minus VBE divided by R3. So IE3 is equal to 2VD minus VBE divided by R3. So IE3 is equal to VD divided by R3. So as we know that, as we know that here the VD, so the diode voltage, which is equal to VBE, which is approximately equal to VBE. That is, I think that that is around 0.7 volts for a silicon transistor or a silicon diode. For a silicon diode, it is 0.7 volts VD, and for a silicon transistor, it is around 0.7 volts VBE. So both will get cancelled, and finally we are going to get IE3 is equal to VD by R2. The diode and transistor here, the point we have written here, the diode and transistor are having the same characteristics. VD is equal to VBE. Same characteristics, then the diode voltage is equal to the base to emitter voltage. Nothing but here, base to emitter is nothing but a diode. It is also a diode. So as these two are silicon devices, so these two voltages are equal. VD is the voltage due to, so here VD is the voltage due to I, that is voltage due to the current I across R1. So then the VD is the voltage due to I across R1. IE3 can be varied by changing R1. IE3 is equal to VE minus 2VD by R1. R1 is equal to VE minus 2VD divided by IE3. So by this we can say that IE3 is equal to E minus 2VD divided by R1. E minus IE3 is equal to, that is IE3 is equal to E minus 2VD, E minus 2VD divided by R1, resistance in this path. So because in this path we are having the resistance only R1. So R1 is equal to V minus 2VD divided by V3. So this IV3 depends upon the constant voltage V and 2VD and R1. So it is not going to depend upon VD, a transistor parameter. It is going to depend upon diode voltage VD. So if a transistor the transistor is going to change its temperature, it can be compensated with diode voltage. So by this, if transistor voltage is going to change, that is, if VD changes, then VD is also going to change. So see here in this equation, if temperature changes, VD is going to change. Temperature changes, then VD is also going to change because both are silicon devices. So this will balance the current. This will balance the current IE3. So because of this balancing, so we can eliminate the drawbacks in the above circuit. So by replacing R2 with these two diodes. So now another circuit we are going to consider in the same manner. Here we are going to use in the above circuit we have used the PN junction diodes. Here we are going to use the Jena diode. So in the place of PN junction diode, we are going to use the Jena diode. So this is also a constant bias, constant current bias using Jena diode. The constant the Jena diode is used instead of B1 and B2. So because of choosing two diodes, here we are going to consider a single Jena diode. And we are going to replace the two diodes with a single Jena diode. So our aim is to decrease the size of the circuit. So what we are going to implement in an IC, so we have to decrease the size of the circuit without affecting any parameters. So that is why we are going to replace the two PN junction diodes with a Jena diode and maintaining constant current of V3. So here, with the help of the Jena diode, VB is equal to minus VE plus VJ, nothing but minus VE plus VJ. So VE is equal to VB, again VE is equal to VB minus VBE. So minus VE plus VJ minus VBE. So IE3 is equal to VE plus VE divided by R3. That is equal to VJ minus VBE divided by R3. So we are going to see here. So IE3, that is the current, is going to depend upon Jena voltage and VBE and R3. So as temperature is going to change, the VBE is going to change, as well as Jena voltage is also going to change. So this will balance the equation and provide the constant current without any effect. So in this way, these are providing the constant currents and maintaining the parameters constant. So RN, here we have to think that RN has to be selected such that it allows Jena diode to conduct in reverse bias also. So here we have to keep in mind this, we have to select the RN such that it allows the Jena diode to conduct in reverse bias condition also. So this is about the constant current bias using Jena diode. As we have discussed three circuits now, so you can see here the first circuit is constant current bias circuit. So the constant current bias circuit using the resistors, so R1, R2 and R3. Again the constant current bias using, this is having the drawback, that is if the temperature changes in there, then the value of the current is going to change. So it does not maintain the constant current. So because of that it faces some problems. So this can be eliminated by using diodes, two diodes. So you see here, with the help of two diodes, we are going to eliminate the temperature effect and balancing by using these two diodes. And then these two diodes can also be replaced with a single Jena diode and maintain a constant current. So up to now we have seen constant current bias using these three methods, and now we are going for current mirror. So as you have know that the mirror is nothing but a mirror is which is going to produce the same image in opposite direction. So our image, which is going to produce our image, and it will show in opposite direction. So that is what the same thing here, this current mirror is also going to work in the same manner. Source current is going inside, then it will show the sea current that is coming from that side. So it is named as current mirror. So the output of current mirror is the image of input current. Nothing but the output of current mirror is the image of input current. So here this is the current mirror circuit. This is the block diagram. II is equal to nothing but input current is equal to output current I naught. II is the input current and I naught is the output current. So this is the current mirror circuit. You can see here this is the current mirror circuit. So coming to here analysis part. So Q3, Q4 are matched transistors. Here we are going to consider this two transistors are matched transistors which are having the same characteristics. So matched transistor means these are having the same HFE values, that is nothing but same beta values and same base currents and the same base emitter voltage drop. So you see here VBE3 is equal to VBE4, that is the base emitter drop of this Q4 transistor is equal to base emitter drop of this Q3 transistor, and IB3, that is the base current of Q3 transistor, is equal to the base current of Q4 transistor, as well as IC2, that is the collector current of Q3 transistor, is equal to the collector current of Q4 transistor. So now we are going to place a node at this part. You can see, so we have placed a node at collector of Q4 transistor as a small a. And the base of Q4 transistor, which is connected to the base of Q3 transistor, and that node we are calling it as B. And here you can see that A, B are same. A, B nodes are same, but we are considering this different. So now we are going to write why we have taken these nodes means for writing this KCL. So KCL at node A. So at node A we are going to write the KCL. So at node A. So I2 is equal to I plus IC4. I2 is equal to I plus IC4. So at node A here you can see I2 is the current of flowing through R2 and coming in this direction. So at node A it is going to divide into two parts. So it is going to divide as I and it is going to divide as IC4. That's what we are going to write here. That is I2 is equal to I plus IC4. So the current flowing through this R2 is going to come in this direction and it is going to divide into two parts, that is IC4 and I. So that's what we have written here. And KCL at node B, and we are considering this at node B, I is equal to, so entering current is nothing but I, and leaving currents are nothing but IB3 and IB4. That's what we have written here. I is equal to IB3 plus IB4. So I is equal to, we can write it as, because as you have assumed here, you can see IB3 is equal to IB4, IC3 is equal to IC4. So in the place of IB3, I can write IB4. In the place of IB4, I can write IB3. So by replacing that, we can write I is equal to 2IB3, or it may also be written as I is equal to 2IB4. So I is equal to 2IB3, or it may be written as 2IB4. So finally, in this equation, I2 is equal to, in the place of I, we are going to write IB3 or IB4. So here you can see, so I2 is equal to IC4 plus 2IB4, or you can write IC3 plus 2IB3. So you can take the parameters of Q4 transistor, or you can take the parameters of Q3 transistor. So IB3 is equal to IC3 by beta. So we know that beta is equal to IC by IB. So we know this relation, that is beta is equal to IC by I3. So using that relation, we can write this base current is equal to IC3 by beta. And in the same manner, IB4 is equal to IC4 by beta. So in the place of IB4, in the place of base current, we are going to write collector current. So I2 is equal to IC3 plus IC3 into 2 by beta. So as 2 by beta value is very small, as beta is large, because beta is around 100, so 2 by 100 will become very small value. 2 by 100 will become a very small value, so 0.002, nothing but 02, 0.02, so it is very small value. So IC plus IC3 into that small value will become very small, and we can say that IP is equal to IC3. So we can say that I2 is equal to IC3. So because of that, here you see the current this is coming from, that IC3 current is coming from the emitter terminal of differential amplifier, and IP is the current flowing through R2. So finally we have proved that IP is equal to IC3, that is I2, the current flowing through R2 is equal to IC3. That means this is the image, mirror image of input current. So here input current is IC3 and this is the mirror image current, that is I2. Both are having equal magnitude. So see here, because of that term, it provides a constant current. This circuit provides a constant current, and this provides a high resistance value. By writing the KVL to the input loop, in the loop of K3 transistor, we have K3 transistor loop into the KVL. So I2 into R2. So I2 into R2. So in this loop, see in this loop, this loop. So I am going to show it again. So in this loop, we are going to write the KVL. So minus I2 into R2. Minus VBE3, there is no voltage drop because there is no resistance in this part, and the same current is going to flow in this direction. So here, coming here, that is VBE3. I think that is what we have written here, minus VBE3. So in this part, we are going to come here and coming to V minus of minus V is equal to 0. So from this equation, we can write I2, we can derive the I2 value. So I2 is equal to VE minus VBE3 divided by R. So here you can see from this equation, if you find the value of I2 value, you find the value of I2, that depends upon the supply voltage VE, which is constant, the goes to emitter resistance, the voltage, so which is a fixed value, which is a fixed value, nothing but, and R2. R2 is also a resistance and which is a fixed value. So because of these three fixed values, so the current I2 is also going to be fixed. So this is a current mirror operation. So this is how it is going to produce the mirror current. That is I2 is the mirror current of IC3. So this is about the current mirror. And next coming to input current mirror. So if beta is small, then I2, as we have considered beta value here, if beta is small, then I2 is approximately equal to IC3. So modified current mirror. So this is the modified current mirror. So here we are going to use another transistor, that is three transistors we are going to use, Q1, Q2, and Q3. So here KCL at node B. So see here we are having the nodes B, node B, and different nodes. So we are going to write our KCL at node B. So input current is I1. We are entering into the transistor Q3, so we can write I1 is equal to, I1 is equal to IB2, the base current. So I1 is going to divide into two parts at this node B, that is IB3 and IC1. So we are going to write that I1 is equal to IB3 plus IC1. By seeing this this circuit diagram, we can write like this. So Q1 and Q2 are matching transistors, so IB1 is equal to IB2 is equal to IB. So Q1 and Q2, we are going to consider those three of these two as passive transistors. So IB, IB1 is equal to IB2 is equal to IB. So because both are, both the currents are equal because they are identical transistors. So hence IC3 is equal to 2IB and IB3 is equal to 1 plus beta into IB3. So IB3 is nothing but the output of this Q3 transistor. So it is going to divide into two parts here. So you can write 1 plus beta into IB3. And how we have written this? So see here. By seeing this, you can write IC is equal to beta IB and IB is equal to IC plus IB and beta IB plus IB. So we are going to write it as 1 plus beta into IB. So by using this relation, we are going to write here IE3 is equal to 1 plus beta into IB3. So 2IB is equal to 1 plus beta into IB3. In the place of IE3, we are going to write this value. So 2IB is equal to 1 plus beta into IB3. So as we know that IC1 is equal to IE1 is equal to beta IB and IC2 is equal to IE2 is equal to beta IB. So I1 is equal to beta IB plus 2 into IB by 1 plus beta. So I1 is equal to, so we are going to get I1 is equal to, so in the place of this equation, I1 is equal to IB3, as we have written IB3. So IB3 is equal to beta IB, by 1 is equal to beta IB, so beta IB plus 2 into IB by 1 plus beta, 2 into IB by 1 plus beta, as we have found the value of IB3 and IC1. So we are going to replace here because IE1 is equal to IC1. So we are going to write it as beta IB and IC2 is equal to IE2 is equal to beta IB. So we are going to write it as beta IB and IC1. IC1 is equal to, so here we have found IC1 is equal to beta IB. So 2 into IB divided by 1 plus beta, we are going to write it here. I1 is equal to IB into beta into 1 plus beta plus 2 by solving this equation. So finally we are going to get IC2 is equal to beta IB, IB is equal to IC2 by beta. From this beta equation we are going to write this, and IC2 is equal to beta into I1 plus I1 into 1 plus beta divided by beta into 1 plus beta plus 2. So IC2 is equal to IC1 is equal to I2 is equal to, finally we are going to get I1 into beta into 1 plus beta, beta into 1 plus beta plus 2. So I1 by I2 by I1 is equal to beta into 1 plus beta divided by beta into 1 plus beta plus 2. So this is how we are going to get the current equation for this improved current mirror. So this advantages of this current mirror is, so it provides a high emitter resistance, requires less components, it provides a high emitter resistance as well as it requires less components, simple to design, thermal stability, that means it can, if the temperature changes, it can withstand, I think the thermal stability means, so thermal stability and simple to design, because it is having only transistors, you can see here, so because of this, using only transistors, there is no resistance effect because placing a resistor in on a silicon chip occupies a large space. It can be reduced by replacing that resistance with a semiconductor device. So here in this current mirror, you can see there is no resistance here, and when you are having the transistors, the transistors can be simply manufactured on a silicon chip. So this can be implemented easily. That is a main advantage of improved current mirror. This is one of the technique. That is by improving why you are going for this cost and current source. So for increasing the value of differential gain, so we are going to increase the resistance. That is emitter resistance value. So if you increase the emitter resistance value practically, so it will occupy more area and draws more current. So because of this disadvantage, so we are going for constant bias circuit and we are going for current mirror circuit. So in this constant current bias circuit, we have discussed the three circuits, constant current bias circuit and constant current bias circuit using diodes and constant current bias using Jenner diode. And another one is another circuit which is going to provide the constant current bias is nothing but emitter, that is a mirror, current mirror circuit. So current mirror circuit, how it is going to reduce constant current, as we have seen that, and also how it is going to produce the constant current, we have observed that, and also we have observed improved current mirror also. So these are the topics we have discussed up to now. And next, so another circuits are there for improving CMRR. So that is for increasing AD. So another concept is there for increasing AD. So that is nothing but the collector resistance. By increasing the collector resistance, so the AD is also increased. But practically, a higher biasing voltage is needed. By increasing the collector resistance, it needed a higher biasing voltage and requires a large chip area. So how we are going to consider this? Once again, we are going to look into the AD equation. That is a differential gain equation. Going to the differential gain equation. And so see here, coming to the differential gain equation. So we are going to observe the differential gain equation. So differential gain, we are going to observe. So coming to the differential gain, so see here AD, which is a differential gain. So what we have observed here, so a differential gain AD, which is equal to HFE into RC divided by RS plus HIE. So differential gain can be increased by increasing this, that is collector resistance value. So because of this, so we are going to now we are going to consider increasing the collector resistance value. So if we increase the collector resistance value also, then we can increase the differential gain. So now what we have discussed today, that is a current mirror circuit, what we have discussed up to now, that is the current mirror circuit. We are going to use this current mirror circuit in the place of collector resistor. So by placing that in the place of collector resistor, that is RC, so it can provide a constant current as well as high resistance. So because of just providing high resistance, so it increases the current, it increases the differential gain of a differential amplifier. So if differential gain increases, then CMRR is going to increase. So if CMRR is going to increase, the common mode voltage will be zero. So that first differential amplifier is going to provide a better gain. So nothing but. So here you can see this circuit where RC, in the place of this is a differential amplifier circuit, in the place of RC we are going to use the current mirror circuit. That is a current mirror circuit is nothing but with the help of transistors we are going to use the current mirror circuit. So here we are only using the active components, that is the two transistors. So it is called, it is also called as active load. So it is also called as active load. If ES1 is equal to ES2 is equal to 0, Q1 and Q2 are massive transistors, then I1 is equal to I2 is equal to I by 2. So I1 is the current in this direction and I2 is the current of this transistor, which is equal to I by 2. So I is the current of this current source, this is the current source, constant current source, where I is equal to I1 is equal to I2, Q3 and Q4 are act as a current repeaters, Q3 and Q4 act as a current repeaters. So IL is equal to I minus I2, IL is equal to I minus I2. So IL, here you can see IL is a load current which is equal to the current I minus I2. IL is equal to I minus I2. So you can, we can also say that I is equal to IL plus I2, nothing better. So from this we can say that IL is equal to I minus I2, nothing better. So we are going to write that I minus I2 which is equal to 0. So when VS1 is increasing, when compared with VS2, the current I1 increases. When VS1 is greater than VS2, let us say when VS1 is greater than VS2, then I1 is going to increase, whereas I2 is going to decrease. When I1 is increasing, then I2 is going to decrease. So I1 plus I2 is equal to I, which is constant. So if I1 increases, I decreases. If I2 increases, I1 increases. So it maintains a constant emitter current and also maintains a constant emitter current. If I is equal to I1, hence due to the current mirror action. So if VS1 increases or VS2, I1 increases and I2 decreases, since I1 plus I2 is equal to IE. So in this way, it provides a constant, it provides a high RC, that is a high collector resistance, and which provides a high, when it is having a high collector resistance, then it improves the differential gain AD. So this is how we are going to improve the differential gain AD. And another concept is nothing but by increasing the value of input resistance also, that is RS. So as we have observed it, AD or AC is going to depend upon RS value also, that is a source resistance RS value also. So RS can also be input resistance, that is input resistance can also be increased. So if the input resistance is going to increase, then we can increase the differential gain and we can decrease the common mode gain also. So the resistance over the differential amplifier, the differential input signal is called input resistance, that is RID. So RID is equal to HIE1 plus HIE2. So here, two identical transistors we are going to take here, Q1, Q2. In the place of RS, we are going to take here two transistors, I1 and I2, which are having internal resistances, that is HIE1 and HIE2. HIE can be increased by రిడ్యూసింగ్ బయాసింగ్ కరెంట్స్ ఫర్ క్లీనింగ్ క్యూపీ హెచ్ఐ కెన్ ఇంక్రీజ్డ్ హెచ్ఐ మనం అలా ఇంక్రీజ్ చేసుకోవచ్చు హెచ్ఐ కెన్ ఇంక్రీజ్ బై బయాసింగ్ బై ఇంక్రీజ్ బై రిడ్యూసింగ్ ద బయాసింగ్ కరెంట్స్ ఫర్ క్యూ1 అండ్ క్యూ2 దిస్ కెన్ బి అచీవ్డ్ బై డార్లింగ్టన్ పేర్ డార్లింగ్టన్ పేర్ ప్రొవైడ్స్ సో దిస్ కెన్ బి అచీవ్డ్ బై డార్లింగ్టన్ పేర్ డార్లింగ్టన్ పేర్ హియర్ యూ కెన్ సీ దిస్ ఈస్ నథింగ్ బట్ డార్లింగ్టన్ పేర్ సో డార్లింగ్టన్ పేర్ విచ్ ప్రొవైడ్స్ హై ఇన్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ and Darlington provides a high input resistance so it has large current going that is it has high beta value as it is a multiple of beta nothing but here you can see that beta 1 into beta 2 so it is multiple so let us say beta 1 is 100 and beta 2 is 100 then 100 into 100 will becomes what 100 into 100 which is nothing but 10,000 so the gain is more very much more So again, it is having high current gain. The current gain is more. The current gain of a single transistor is 100, then the Darlington board has a gain of 10,000, you can see here. So by increasing the input resistance also, so we can increase the value of differential gain. So we know that, so by using these, we are going to improve the differential gain so HFE so here you can see AD is equal to HFE into RC the RS plus HFE so with this we will complete this class and in the next class we will continue thank you students